Hi, Lexi. All right, so I'm just gonna be trying out some new products. Oh God. My setup here. Sorry if I seem kind of out of it this morning and not too chipper. Just going through some stuff. So I figure I just do this for fun. Cheer me up. So anyways, I cleaned my face and I've been having a lot of problem lately with dry lips. So I'm all about exfoliating. So I just wash my face because I always say, you know, wash your face before you do makeup. That's a must. You'll notice a big difference if you don't wash your face and put on makeup versus you do wash your face and put on makeup. So, and I also used, I don't really like using a lot of Clinique makeup products anymore, but I still love their skincare line. So I do use the 7-day exfoliating scrub. I will always use it. I love it. I've had that for maybe a year or so. You're not really supposed to keep a lot of products that long, but... so yes, I exfoliated. I did my regular washing my face, the clean and clear morning burst with, you know, the Clarisonic brush. And then I, the 7-day exfoliate. I did the scrub first, then washed my face. So now I've been having a lot of problems with dry lip, and that's probably because I don't drink a lot of water. So I like to exfoliate my lips. The exfoliator I like to use, and I've been using this for a while, I love it. I used to have the Bobbi Brown exfoliating lip thing, and that's good, but when I ran out, because it is expensive, Bobbi Brown, I decided to go with the drugstore brand. So I've had this one for quite a while, but it's the e.l.f. Lip exfoliator. So you want your, I would tend to do this after you wash your face. Sorry, still getting over sickness. So, do that, wash your face, then exfoliate your lips. So it's like pretty cool. I don't know if y'all can see it. Can't wait to actually get like a... it's not focusing in. But anyways, it's got a little exfoliator stuff in there. So you want clean, dry, clean, dry lips. Then you're gonna take it and just in circular motions. Oh, see, yeah. And you'll feel like... it'll feel like kind of like sandpaper almost. Not like it's gonna hurt sandpaper, but it's exfoliating your lips. You'll see a big, if you have dry lips and have big dry lips, you'll see a big difference when you do this. I just do that for about a minute or so on bottom and top. I'm all about exfoliating, guys. There's also, I do it once a week, a homemade exfoliator lip scrub. Kind of, it's like more of a deeper, I do that, like I said, once a week. Mix of like honey. I'll put the recipe up for it. But it's good. If you have like, you know, dry lips, and I mean, it's good to keep your lips and skin exfoliated, so... so there we go. Alright, so after you exfoliate your lips, you take a clean, damp cloth. And I used this already for earlier and washed my face. And just wipe it off smoothly. What you say? I love it. All right, and then you follow it with lip balm or a gloss. I like to just use my regular chapstick. So I have Blistex. Awesome, thank you.
Or you left?
Yep. I'm like, I need my fountain soda. Baby boy is hurting. He accidentally put his hand on the iron this morning. I mean, the iron wasn't on, but it was like cooling off. I'm sitting there for about a good 30 minutes. I know, I just talked about I don't drink enough water and I'm drinking fountain soda. I need to. So anyways, if you're just jumping on, I clean my face, I exfoliate it, and I exfoliate my lips. The lip exfoliator I use is the e.l.f. lip exfoliator. It's only $4, guys, so it's good. And then I follow it with my chapstick. And you'll see like a huge difference when you put on your lip stain, lip gloss, lippy. So my dad and them just got this like huge TV. So if you hear that in the background, he's like having fun with it. They got like a 65-inch 14K TV or some crap. All right, so I did that. No, I'm just gonna do my eyes. I love the way that e.l.f. lip exfoliator makes my lips feel so smoothy. So Ava was excited about school today because we're having a pizza party. Ta-da! Guys, I'm gonna show you in just a minute. I like stocked up on lashes, and I have lashes coming in the mail as well. So, hi, babe. All right. I'm just using concealer as eye primer. I don't know if like the TV is louder than me right now. No, I'm not. It's Mason. Look at him. He's like, my girlfriend's getting ready. Babe, you know what Tristan did? So, my mom used iron board this morning, and they had it unplugged and cooling off. We were sitting there for maybe an hour, being hot, still kind of hot. Yeah, Tristan. You know, nosy, curious little Tristan, when we told him multiple times, went up and touched it. So me and Gregory this morning had to go to CVS and get some stuff for him, his hand. He's probably going to be a little grumpy all day. I'm supposed to be meeting up a friend for lunch. Name is Brittany. I haven't seen that girl in forever. And out of nowhere, the girl is like, beautiful boys. Like, that's how long I haven't talked to her. Like, all these boys. I know she wants a girl. Because I want to have another girl. Ava wants another sister. She's like, I want a little sister. Who the heck? Gregory? You guys, you're so stupid. So anybody new jumping on, I washed my face this morning, exfoliated as well. I like to exfoliate once a week, twice a week if I can.
and I exfoliated my lips, and I used the e.l.f. lip scrub, and it was only $4. So, $4, people. So you have a problem with dry lips? Go get that. Oh my gosh, y'all don't understand, like I cannot wait till my big ring light comes in. Like I can already see a difference. I have this small one clipped on my phone right now and I can see a major difference. But with the big one, it comes with a big stand, tripod stand, six foot stand or something. And it'll be even a lot better, so. Again, I'm not really going in to a lot of like makeup details, just doing this video for fun, kind of cheer me up because I had a really, really crappy day yesterday. Like I'm starting to not like humans. Maybe Jacksonville humans, I don't know. Because I get along with everybody on the internet. Alright. Sorry. Okay, so, oh, I have got to show you, I stocked up on some eyelashes, my lashies, and I have my House of Lashes and Lash, if you want to order online and you want some good brands, not too expensive, there is House of Lashes and there's Lash in a Box, love them, and Lash in a Box is cheap and you, I mean, it's not cheaply made, but it's kind of more inexpensive, and they give you like a big box, almost like this. This is only $5, guys, at Five and Below. So I'm gonna try it out. I always love to try out new stuff. So this is by Smoke and Mirrors. I always like to look when I purchase lashes. I always like to look at the band width. And I can tell without even putting it on whether it's cheaply made and it's gonna come up all the time or it looks good. And this one looks like it's good. So, and you get different styles in it. $5, Five and Below. If you like wearing lashes. And then I bought these. I'm like lash crazy. At CVS, it was buy one, get one 50% off. I got the Ardell. This one is the 101 Demi. I like this one. You see my ring light up in there. See how beautiful that is? I love it. Ardell's are always, and Vegas Nay. Oh my gosh. I love her lashes too. And then this one's Andrea. I haven't tried this one, so we'll see. But number 33, black. That's pretty. See, the more darker type the band is, that's how you know it's gonna be good. So, just from experience, so I'm like stocked up on lashes, yay. But that Salon Perfect one I got from Walmart was good, and that was inexpensive too. But I can't wait till I get my House of Lashes and lashes in a box, and I love that stuff. All right, so I need to quit talking. Okay, so I yesterday got the BH Cosmetics Carly. I've been following her like forever on YouTube, so, and I've been wanting this for a while, so I'm so glad I got it. Aspire, oh, I love that. Look at that. It says Aspire to Inspire. All right, let me shut up. I always like keeping these things on. I don't know if I'm the only one who does that. I'm sure I'm not the only one, but I'm just saying most people will take it out. And so just gonna use my regular. This is like a non-name brand eyeshadow brush. It's like my favorite. I have the Sigma one, but I just, for some reason, the main one on my lid, I like using this. That's why sometimes it's not always about the brand and the price of it. Because I have had expensive makeup. I mean, I always had expensive makeup, but I'm talking about from experience that I've had some expensive makeup that wasn't so great. So, all right. And I'll be quite honest, Kat Von D stepped her game up with her brand line, because when it first came out, I hated the quality of her, not hate, because I hate a strong word, but I disliked her quality of her eyeliner and her eyeshadows. Like, it was so much fallout, I disliked it. Now, I love her, the tattoo eyeliner, that, oh my gosh, it's so good. Love it, love it. And now her eyeshadows are better, and she's got rockin' lipsticks. I have quite a few, so she stepped her game up, made better quality makeup. So even her makeup brushes are good now, too. I didn't really like it in the beginning. So usually I like to do a lighter color on the highlight brow area, but she doesn't have one. I mean, I could do this one, but I'll mix up my... Okay. Let's do a different one. Let's switch it up. Let me try a different palette. Let's get one of my naked palettes. Naked too. Oh. You've got, if you love matte eyeshadow, this is one of my favorite matte eyeshadow palettes by Kat Von D. This one's the Lady Bird. I love it, love it, love it. And I love that orangey rustic tone color. That is, oh my gosh. Do that with the brown and it makes your eyes like totally pop and put a little bit underneath the eye. That smoky look with a light brown shade over it, and it's perfect. Alright, so I'm gonna use this palette. No, it's not like that. One's easy to make it. I have like thousands to choose from, and just don't wanna waste, you know, because I get excited about new products and then I tend to forget about the ones, my older ones I have. So I'm gonna go ahead and use Foxy out of the Naked 2 palette. See? Foxy. He's a beautiful man. I love Blake Shelton. And he's funny as heck, too. And I'm sorry, but I think he's cute with Gwen. They are cute together. I've always loved her from, like, the No Doubt days. When I was, like, younger. I heard her, listened to her in sixth grade. Landmark middle school days. I gotta check my phone. But my friend Brittany is leaving town today to, she's going to the Bruno Mars concert. Lucky. Yeah. Can't say it on live. But, like, now I'm, like, freaked out. Like, I've never been to a concert before in my life, and now I'm, like, freaked out to go to a concert because, you know, all the crap you hear. Alright, so I did the... that. Also, I don't know what happened to mine, but as you can tell when I do, like, changing in between makeup brushes, I used to use, I don't know if you guys ever heard of Vera, it's like Vera Monet or something like that. It's a little, it looks like a little circle sponge type thing. It's perfect, and it's not expensive at all. I just don't know what happened to mine, so that's why I've been using this lately. Alright, so I'm going to pick What color should I do? They're just all so pretty. Knowing my butt, I'm gonna go straight to the matte. So yeah, I'm going to the matte, my matte eyeshadows. Maybe I'll do a little one of the sparkle ones on the lid. All right, so I'll just go ahead and go in with this. I don't know what color that is. It actually does not have any name to it, so. But this is that BH Cosmetic Carly by Bell. Sorry, still getting over sickness, so. And I'm just patting that straight on top of the crease area above the eyelid, because I'd like to do a lighter color on my lid part. It's gonna look funny at first when you do it, but that's why you blend. Oh, I love it. And like, you got a lot of product on it, and it's like comes out and there's barely any fallout. I like that. That's like the two things I look for. Which I should probably just do that in the store, because then I'm like wasting my money. Take it home and then test it. But two things I look for in eyeshadows: how much fallout, and when I shouldn't have to, like, you know, dig into it to get a lot of the product on it so it stands out on my eye. So this is good. I love it. I love the quality so far. This is not a country song. This is Kobe Calais Bubbly, right? I think it is. Hold on. Yeah. I set it on a country playlist. I don't know how that ended there, because it's not country to me. All right. I swear, you guys, like, I'm, like, losing my mind lately. I really am. So I'm just gonna blend that out. I'm using my Sigma blending brush E36. And just going above it, do a back and forth windshield wiper mode. I always say, I'm not gonna do a makeup tutorial, and then I just start talking. I go, this is what you do. This is how you do this way. And you just do it that way. So weird. Wow, this product really stays on. It's taking me a lot longer to have to blend the top of it. And it's a good thing though. And I love BH Cosmetics. I was so tempted last night. Oh my god. So tempted. Because it wasn't sold out. The Jaclyn Hill Morph Palette. I was so tempted. But like, I spent so much money yesterday on makeup already at the store. So. Now I'm just going underneath because I want to blend that out. Wow, this color really stays on. Or eyeshadow. I mean, that's a good thing, so. Going to the side. I'll play with it more in a minute. Because I don't want to be stuck here for 2 hours again. I just gotta, like, cheer myself up, because going through crappy, like, it's one of those things where you go through something really stressful in your life, and then people do not make it easier at all. Like, rude people, can't say please, can't say thank you, you know, like, from the store, just from everywhere. It's just so like aggravating. So when you're going through something stressful in your life and then you have to deal with like rude, ungrateful people, like it just really irks me. And like I can be a B-I-T-C-H, but it takes me a lot to get to that point, especially if it's like a stranger or someone I really don't talk to. But lately I've been more snappy. I don't mean to be. I just... And people are crazy. See? He knows what he's singing about. So funny even talking about that. Alright. Let me shut up. Alright, so on my lip part, I want to go a little bit lighter, so I'm going to go with this one. It sucks that they don't have like names or number or something to it. I mean, yeah. I know I said I was going to do an cut crease eye tutorial for you guys, but I'll do it this weekend. Put a little concealer over the lid. Make it pop a little bit more, but that's okay. I cannot wait to play with these. New lashes, hopefully they look good. So I'm just patting because I want to get most of the product onto the eye. If I'm sitting there going back and forth to eyeshadow, I'm basically smearing it out and have a lot of fallout. So when I'm on the lid, I like to pat on. My blending brush again. Yeah, I need to like invest back into that. So I'm just going above it. Alright, I'm going to go a little bit more back up top with the first color on my lid. Going back over and blending. Alright, Carly. Oh my gosh. Also, you guys, there's a... Get him! I know it looks funny, but get him, Sharita. I'm telling you. Oh, and Sharita, I don't know if they have a Five and Below store near you, but I like stocked up on like a crap load of lashes. I have some coming in the mail from the ones I normally like to wear, but this one at Five and Below is $5, right? And you get all of these. And they have, there's different styles in them. And I was telling them earlier, I like to look, when I purchase the lashes, I like to look at the bandwidth on it to see if it'll be good. And if it's usually thick like that and black, that's a good sign that it's good. Not too thick, but $5. Five and Below. I don't know if they have one on your side of town, but. And then CVS right now has buy one, get one 50% off. So I got some Ardell lashes. There you go. And then that one. I haven't used this one before, so. Well, I haven't used this or the Five and Below, so we'll see. Yeah. And yes, I have to wear these eye shields to do my wing look. It's like I haven't mastered yet how to do a wing look by myself, like free-handed. So. Alright, I think I'm done blending out. Now I'm going with a darker color in the crease. Alright. I'm like lash galore up here. Oh my gosh. It's funny. Sorry, I'm trying to get situated. So again, anyone new? Like I said this morning or earlier, I washed my face, exfoliated my face before I did my makeup, and I used the 7-Day Clinique exfoliator scrub, and then after that, I exfoliated my lips with e.l.f., and that's only $4, so e.l.f. lip exfoliator, and my lips feel amazing. You just do a circular motion. Your lips have to be clean. Gosh, I wish it would just focus. That's why I need like an actual professional camera, because it's not like, it's not gonna do it. But anyway, it's got little exfoliator beads, scrubs in there. So you do that, you do a circular motion. I like to do it for about a minute or so. Then you take a damp, wet cloth, wipe it off, and then follow it with lip balm or chapstick or gloss, whatever. I do chapstick. And perfect. So when you do your lips later, it's going to feel nice and not so cracky looking and dry. So anyways, let me decide which color I'm going in the dark crease now. Let me see the colors I have right now. Okay, so it's kind of like a mauve color, so we'll do this. That's got a little bit of shimmer in it. I want like a darker. Alright, so I'll go in with this one down here. This is a little darker. I'm going to go take my blending diffuse crease Sigma brush, not blending, sorry. Just tap that in. I'm going with my crease. I don't want to be too dramatic on my eyes today. I'm just coming from the end. I love these eyeshadow shields. Perfect for the fallout of eyeshadow and your wing. Like, when I came across this 4 years ago, I was like in love. I'm like, ah. But I would suggest buying it. You can buy it at Walmart or wherever. It's gonna, you don't get that many in a box. Then when you purchase it offline from the actual company, you get a whole lot more. Going back and forth in my crease. Look at that. You see how I need that? So I just go back and forth in there. So these eyeshadows are okay. I like them. It wouldn't be my favorite, but I like them. I don't know if it's just like, doesn't look as, I don't know how to explain it. So on a scale from 1 to 10 to 10, I absolutely love it. It'll probably be like a 7. So it's okay. It's not bad, but it's not like, whoa, pretty. Like my Lorac. That's what I was going to say. The Lorac. Oh my gosh, guys. It's a big, like, ugh. I need to go back and get it. It's like $59 or something, but it's a limited edition. And I love Lorac. Ooh, I love Lorac. My sister stole my big one. Thanks to her. So I'm never getting that back. Actually, I think she said she ended up using all of it. So, yeah, it's my favorite. Eyeshadow-wise, I love Lorac. Lorac is one of my go-to eyeshadows, along with Urban Decay. Their Naked palettes. And then that Ultimate Basic. Ultimate. Yeah, these eyeshadows isn't like as like amazing as I thought it was going to be. I mean, it's not bad. I don't know. It just feels like it's taken me a lot longer to blend it, and I don't know. Maybe it's the colors I'm not fond of. I don't know. But, I mean, it's not bad. Like I said, I'm sorry. It's not bad. If you have it and you love it, that's good. You know, everyone's just got different opinions. This one's just, I don't know. There's something in the quality it's made that doesn't look like... I don't know. Never mind. I'm just going to shut up. I'm just gonna take a flat brush. And I'm going to do a. Let's see how the shimmer ones are. Let's see what kind of colors I got going on. To make my brighter, because this is how you also do that cut crease, to make your eye pop a little bit, I'm going to. You can also wet your brush. I'm going to want to go right here. So I'm putting a little bit more concealer just in the middle of my lid, because that's where I'm just going to put the shimmer eyeshadow part. It's going to look funny, but you'll see what I mean. And I'll blend it out after I put the eyeshadow on it. When you've already put eyeshadow on and you want to put a lighter color to make it pop or a shimmer eyeshadow, you want to reapply concealer in the part you want. You could also use the NYX Milk Jumbo. That's for also more brighter colors if you're trying to do like the bright pinks, teal, blue, bright purple. I would suggest using this instead of just the regular concealer. Oh, and I've got to show you guys before I get off. I'm going to show you the cute little, because we were at Five and Below store yesterday. I got these cute little head bandana fashion headband things, because me and my daughter is going to do a pinup look. I know it looks funny, but trust me, you'll see what I mean in a minute. And they're so cute, the bandana looking. The pinup look. I just gotta practice doing the rolls in the hair. So, all right. So I'm gonna pick. Let's see what shimmer I wanna do. What colors do I got going on? Let's just do something fun. So I'm gonna go with that one. It's like a nice peachy. It's got like a peachy golden look in it. Like a peach with like golden shimmer in it. So we'll just try that out. And I'm gonna wet my brush a little bit. And I don't just like to wet it with regular water. I like to wet it with this. The MAC. Woo-hoo. Some of y'all probably know what this is. The Fix Plus. I love it. I have to get a refill, as you can tell. But it kind of works as the same concept as... my head, I'm getting dizzy. I barely got any sleep last night. I'm like fucking hating life right now. Sorry, smelling which one. It kind of works like this. A setting spray, priming spray, brighter eyeshadows or glitter shimmer eyeshadows. I like to spray the brush. Okay, let that. Just dab it out a little bit so not too bad. Then I'm going to go in. Now I'm doing this with a flat brush, y'all. It's got to be real flat. Flat brush. Alright. Pat. Ooh. That's pretty. That's pretty. Wow, that's really pretty. I don't know if you could see the quality, but it's really pretty. I like that. And the reason why it's standing out so bright, I did good concealer, and then I sprayed a little bit of that setting spray on my flat brush, and I'm patting. Do not go on and crazy with it, because you're just going to be... I should wet my brush again. Hold on. I wet it for one eye, then I need to wet it for the other eye. And I'm going to blend that out, so don't worry. It's going to look funny, but... Patting. That's beautiful. That's really beautiful. I like that. I actually like her shimmer eyeshadow better than her matte, to be honest. And I love me some matte eyeshadows. I prefer matte. But this, her shimmer ones, is pretty nice. So again, make sure you wet your brush with the setting spray. The Max or Mac Fix Plus. Do the concealer first. It's gonna make it pop. Just playing around with it. Have fun today. Cheer me up. Ain't as good as I once was. Pow pow! Yeah! Phlegm. Like, when you get over that sickness, you have that phlegm. Damn. All right, I want to blend out, and I need my. Can I do this one? Exact blend. Yes, that's the one I want. So this is the Sigma, the E32 Exact Blend brush. I'm going to take a little bit of a color because I want to blend out so it doesn't look all crazy looking, right? I'm going to take a color that I had used, like this. The one I originally put on my lid. Under the brow, though. It's going to take just a little bit of that, and I'm going to blend out the edges of where I just did that bright peachy shimmer. I don't want too much. I'm just gonna blend that out so it doesn't look all crazy, you know? Perfect. And then once I put like my eyeliner and lashes on, it's gonna look good. I could have probably gotten all the way more inner. That probably would have been nice. Actually, you know what? Since we're just playing around today, I know what I'm going to do. So I'm just having fun with the eyeshadow and just... Hopefully she tells me we go eat lunch like around noonish, because I'm far from ready because I'm sitting here playing around. You know what I'm going to do? This is what I'm going to do. I'm going to take, because I wanted to maybe just bring in the shimmer part all the way in. So what I'm going to do is take more of my concealer. I'm gonna go back in here. I'm gonna do a different eye shimmer. I just want in the inner crease right here, the inner corner. And I'm just playing around with this, y'all, so. We're gonna see how it comes out. It's gonna be looking banging. Just having fun with it, right? That's the one thing about makeup. You can just sit there and experiment. Okay, I'm gonna take my MAC Fix Plus again. Where are you at? Oh, I'm gonna spray it on the handle. Okay. And I'm gonna do Carly's. Since I did the peachy color shimmer, I'll do, which one looks prettier? That one or that one? Let's do that one. I'm just gonna pick it and go. Alright, so I wet my brush, go with that shimmer, and I'm gonna go on to the inner. So I have two different eye shimmer. Oh yeah. Go back in. And we're gonna blend out the edge, so don't worry, looking all crazy. Alright, I'm gonna wet my brush again for the other eye. See? Play around with your makeup, y'all. You know? Find what works for you. You know, if I started doing this color, these color combinations, and I didn't like it, I'll just go on to a different look. Have fun with it. Find what works for you. That's all it's about. Have fun with it. Ooh, that is pretty. So I've do two different eye shimmers. I love that peachy golden one. That is so pretty. Be here. Let me here. All right, now I'm gonna blend that out. I'm taking that Sigma E32 Exact Blend Brush again, and I'm just gonna blend out. I haven't even actually played with shimmer eyeshadow in a long time, to be honest with you. I'm so used to just doing matte, so I'm kind of excited. It looks so beautiful right now. Go down the middle and blend those two shimmers together. It'll look all crazy. That is beautiful. Oh my god. Gosh. If y'all are here in person, like, it's... I'm proud of myself. So stupid. See, play around. Like, you might come up with a look you like I just did. I love it. It looks so pretty. So I'll take it back. Her eyeshadow palette's maybe not a 7 now. Maybe it's an 8. And that's just because I like the shimmer better than her matte. All right. Looks good. I'm loving it. All right. So that's done. Now, I'm just taking some because I went a lot in her. So I'm just wiping some of that. Because I don't prime my face until I start doing my face. Okay. And I refilled yesterday. He's back. I'm so excited. Like, I cannot do any other liner. I can't. There's no way. I love this. The Tarte's Clay Paint Eyeliner. Oh, I love it. I don't use the brush that's in it. I use my own. Oh my gosh, come on. Oh, so beautiful. Just kiss it. Okay. So. I'm going to put that down. I'm going to do a little smudge. I just took some regular toilet paper. You can use anything. I do not. You can put it on your hand if you want. I only tend to do that when I'm doing other people's faces. There we go. That should be enough. So you don't want too much. Even though it looks like just a tiny bit, trust me, it's more than enough. I probably actually did too much. Because I should just do like one tiny drop, and that's pretty much all you really need. I don't know why I keep it in the box. I just love looking at it. I just like get so happy when I see them. Like, ah! Eyeliner! Tarte eyeliner! Alright, I love using my Sigma eyeliner brush. Where you at, buddy? Okay. There's two Sigma brushes I like using. What did I do with it? Oh, here's one. I have two of them. The Sigma eyeliner. This one's a little bit thicker, so if you want a bigger wing. Gosh, focus. Yeah, if you want a bigger wing, you can use this. But I love playing with this one. This is the eyeliner E11. Sigma even has a waterline liner, the one that you could put up in here on your lid, the waterline, and down here. It's crazy. I have a brush for everything. All right, so I'm just gonna take this. Now, I may not wash my brushes after every use, but the one I do wash and I do recommend you guys doing is your eyeliner brushes, because these products, like gel product, cream products, they harden, and it's a lot tougher to clean when it's already hard enough, so I'm just taking a bit. Right. Okay, so I'm gonna do my wing. Hopefully this is a good wing day. Right. Actually, I have my thing a little too down here. A little more up, angled. Here we go. Stop, my eyelashes are so long that sometimes when I do my eyeliner, I'm not gonna do too crazy on my wing, so. Oh, you know what's another good eyeliner though too? The Sigma. I meant like the gel cream eyeliner Sigma. I use them for all. And then I use this other one. I don't know who it was by, but I used to get Ipsy. Do any of y'all know about Ipsy? Some of y'all probably do. it's a subscription of makeup. You pay $10, I think it was, a month, and then they every month they send you products with different products to try. And there's this one that a little eyeliner pot cream gel, and I have no idea who it's by.
I loved it. Oh my gosh. I'm going like way too high. It's gonna end up looking a little bit more dramatic than I want it. Alright. Hopefully it doesn't look too.
Ah! Perfect. Alright, it's not that bad.
Fix that up in a minute. Like I said, when you do the end of your eye, you don't want to pull back, but I do it anyways when I do on the inside of my eye, because if you do it towards more of the outside, you have more wrinkles and your eyeliner's not gonna look as straight when you pull back because you're straightening out the wrinkles. So who the heck is doing that? Oh, of course, Gregory.
Fixing up my
end of my eye. I love these shimmer eyeshadows. Like,
they're that's so pretty. That peachy golden's like blowing me away.
I'm like, oh my god, it's so pretty.
Alright, that's good enough for now. Sorry. Stop cursing. Get kicked off. Okay, that's fine. I love this stuff. Let me make sure that's more up than I want. Trying so hard not to pull back because I notice a difference when I don't do it versus when I do do it. Even if you don't have these eyeshadow shields, you can use tape. I love this song.
Tomorrow I will be stronger. perfect. Actually, that one looks better than my other eye. Has ever happened to you? Like, one wing liner is working for you and the other one just like, ugh. That's beautiful. Wash this real quick. See my brush cleaner. That's beautiful. Like, I'm loving it. I'm loving it. Let me blend it out a little bit more on that side. Alright. It's done. Where's my blender? There we go. I noticed this. That's better. Okay. Face. Prime. My MAC. I gotta order more of my Unicorn Essence. I don't even know how you pronounce it, this oil. Oh my god, it's like so beautiful on the skin. It feels so hydrating on the skin. Just like loving on your skin, making love on your skin. Just the MAC Moisture, Studio Moisture Cream. Smashbox primer aisle oil. Smashbox primer oil. Tristan's getting in trouble. God, he's like not even two. He's about to be two. And he's already in that terrible two stage. It sucks. But he's been like really bad like that since Josh left. Because like him and Josh are like, you know, Josh is like partner there. Alright. Now, my under. Oh, here we go. This is the Smashbox Photo Op. Brightens up here. So you can wear it by itself, but I wear it underneath my concealer. So and kind of wakens your eye bag area up too. It's got like a almost like a tingling. And just pat that out.
Oh my gosh, you guys. I got like thousands of eyelashes here. Look at, I get lazy and do not want to. Got like two more. So I got lazy and didn't clean yet. Clean them.
So I went out and bought another one. I'm so retarded. My foundation. Just wetting my blender.
If you use brushes when you do your foundation and you use sponges like that over and over, your foundation will start to cake up so bad and look so nasty on your skin. So cleaning your brushes is very important. Cleaning your sponges is very important. I just get lazy and go out and buy more. That's my problem. So, all right. Gonna stick with my Too Faced. And I'm gonna have to switch up. This is too old to use. This one's really old. I've had this. I need to throw that away. I need to switch up my foundation because my skin is very, very dry, but I love using matte foundations. But a lot of matte and pore minimizing stuff is usually for like the oily people or oily skin, and I have way opposite of that. I have very dry skin, so I'm gonna have to start switching up my foundation to have a little bit more moisturizer in it.
I'll just do this.
Oh, I'm running out. That's how you know. Good. Yeah, so it's time for a new one anyways. I do the two foundations, the lighter one I do in the areas that I want to highlight. I'm not going all the way underneath the eye because
love this ball.
There's the foundation. Sorry for not really talking. I'm just like, this is one of those days, like, I'm just like thinking to myself, like, dude, what? I need a miracle right now. This crap I'm going through, like, it's like really, really draining my brain. And this is something we like shouldn't have to be going through right now. Thank you.
I don't even know if Brittany texted me back. I really hope she said like noon.
That's done. Concealer. Here's my Tarte. Or Too Faced, sorry.
The Tarte Shape Tape concealer is good too, guys. I have that as well. Good stuff. I'm using the Too Faced Born This Way concealer. I'm going back in. I'm really sorry, guys. I know I usually talk, but I'm like just really thinking about a lot of stuff. So I'm just going back and forth with the concealer. Remember, you don't want to drag it out. You want to damp it back and forth. And I finished off with my concealer brush. The tapered kabuki brush by Sigma. I refilled my powder yesterday. This powder. So, going in with the Lorac Medium. Love this stuff. Super there. And I need my powder brush. I use this one. The Makeup Addiction, I'm going to use the finisher. Setting my foundation. I love the Lorac powder, face powder. Love it, love it, love it. The two I only use as face powders is the, what's it called? I know I used Bare Minerals last time, but I mainly use, it's like, that's the thing with me. I get stuck to a product and it's like, I don't want to tear away from that product. But then sometimes I had to because they discontinue certain ones I like. Now I'm not going up in my concealer area because I'm going to set that with the Makeup Forever HD Micro Powder. So this brush feels so good. Remember I said if you can't afford like Sigma because it's much more expensive, then go to the Makeup Addiction brushes or more. They're good. Elf. Oh, I love this. Oh my god. I haven't used it in like a long time because the other one I had, I just threw it in the trash too earlier, so I should have showed you guys, like, used it down to like the very end of it. Sure, then I start using the Bare Minerals. The other one I'm about to show you, the face powder I love. And this is the one that the lady told me that she usually recommends people with dry skin. Love it. That is beautiful. Okay. I'm gonna set my under eye with the HD, where you at? Makeup Forever. This white powder looking thing. I'm going right on the concealer areas. Set that. Dang it, I bought this new concealer pack and I was gonna use that to do my contour today, but I just did powder on my face. Stupid. Sorry. Okay. Under setting it. I don't know, I do weird face. I love that shimmer. That I'm like stuck looking at it. That peachy golden look. Okay. Okay, this is that new concealer palette I bought because I'm going to start doing people's makeup as well, so I need a overall thing, but it's a cream. There we go. So it's cream, it's got different colors, so I got that, and I was going to actually do my contouring with that, but I just set the palette, so I'm just going to do my regular NARS contour palette. Finally got a contour brush. It's not the one I wanted because they were sold out of the one I wanted, but this is the Eco Tools. Now this has that NARS, if you probably already know, it's my go-to for contouring, as well as the Anastasia, and I'm gonna go in with that color. My own Anastasia one's a little older, like I told you, I start using new stuff and then see how it does. Start going in the middle. Yeah, see, I don't really like the way that this one feels. It's okay. Don't bring it all the way down. And I'll blend that out. You got no place to go. Going up here. I'm gonna blend that all out. Brush. going with that liner color in the palette. I'm trying to blend this out so I don't have a harsh line. These harsh ends. Alright, that's good enough for me. Actually, I want to do down my nose a little bit. So. I just want like that shadowy look. Now I'll pop once I put my highlighter on. Alright. Picking a blush. I'm just gonna go ahead. I'm gonna go in with this one right there. Brush out the foundation and crop in my eyebrows. Anastasia, dip brow, soft brown. Just lightly tapping it in. Let's start in this area. Thank you. pandemic in small strokes. Remember, you're gonna fix it with your concealer, so. There it goes again. You don't want to be too dark on the inside of your brow here, okay? Should I do the wavy eyebrow? Just kidding. It looks so stupid. Okay. Do the other side and I'm gonna clean it up and go back over whatever I need to fix. Today's not gonna be your best eyebrow day. It's not gonna be a good eyebrow day. I'll be going live later. You guys want to listen in on later. Me and one of my members that signed up under me, Lexi. I am going to be, oh my god, eyelash, or not eyelash, eyeshadow. Anyways, y'all know I work for MCA and I'm doing a bunch of training right now. And it's so crazy, like, how online marketing is just so different, y'all. So different. It's so much to take in. And just like the effing guy says, it's so messy in the beginning. So messy. Because, you know, you're going to be afraid, like, oh, what are my friends and family going to think? But, you know what? It's like he says, your success and failure is on you and no one else. So, if I'm going to become successful, it's going to be because of me. Because of my drive and determination, and I'm building, a followers. Little, you gotta be patient. But me and her are gonna be doing a live video together. So if you guys want to join on later, I'm gonna figure out a time. Yeah, my eyebrows are totally jacked right now. I'm gonna fix it with concealer. If you guys want to join in later, hear her testimony as far as, you know, it's not a scam. I didn't scam her. She got her actual stuff in the mail. I mean, she has background and she's doing good. Her pages and videos are taking off. So, it's better to hear just, instead of just from one person, to hear it from two people. So, and she lives all the way in Pennsylvania, so it's not someone that I told, hey, you gotta help me with this here, you know, lie for me. The chick lives in Pennsylvania, I never met her before, till now. So, and we've clicked. Me and her probably, like, really clicked. So,
which reminds me of me a lot. So, and all my other girls are like freaking wonderful too. And actually, one of them, Stacy, wants me to do a live video with her. So I will probably be doing that next week, I think she said. So I'm pretty excited. A lot of Becky got her first sale. The other, actually, she's up to 3 sales now, and she just started like last week, y'all. So I mean, it's crazy. It's just crazy money. So it's just all about building you, marketing you. So all right, now I'm going to fix my eyebrows because they're jacked. Where's my concealer? Flat brush.
Today.
It's not my day. Where's the flat brush I had?
Oh, there you are.
About to say it. Oh my god. What is up with me? Fix these bad boys. You want a flat brush. The same one I use for my eyeshadow. Let's fix these up.
Not to interrupt you, but I don't want to know if you want a hot dog.
Oh yeah, I'll take one. Side. I'm not really talkative today, am I? Just got so much crap on my mind.
Life sucks sometimes.
Yeah, this one's a lot worse. I gotta fix that one. I love this song. I was playing this song. What's the name of the face powder you use? Oh, it's sorry, Jackie. I don't know if you're still on. It's Lorac, the baked perfecting powder, setting powder, face powder. It's medium. It's really beautiful. Eyebrow gel. Okay.
Oh man, I meant to prime my... See, I'm not with it today.
And this one I'm using is the Lorac Multiple 3D Lashes. Love this.
Not picking my nose, like if you're at that corner.
Okay.
I'm gonna have to buy more. I love that mascara. It's like I watch all these makeup artists on YouTube and I'm like, each video they have some like new products. I'm like, holy crap, like I'm so picky, like I just wanna stick to the ones I like. So I use the same ones over and over and over. I'm about to start learning to branch out because whether I might like someone, someone else might not like it. So I have to start using different products. That's why I'm like going crazy, like growing, and I already have a big enough collection and I'm just going even more crazy. Okay, now I'm gonna do my fake eyelashes. Woo-woo! We're almost done, thank God. Should we do the $5 box?
Never tried these. Let's try these out. These are the Andrea CVS. Buy one, get one 50% off right now, y'all. And this is 33 black. Now I need my... this band. That one's really thin, but we'll work with it. Sometimes thin is not bad. I usually like mine just a little thicker. I like to cut. I don't like them so long, so I cut like more of the inside part towards the inner eye. I just cut just a tiny bit off of it. I use the Duo Eyelash Adhesive Glue. I get the dark one, since I wear dark eyeliner, my eyeshadow is, I mean, natural eyelashes are dark. Comes out like gray looking, but then it, when it softens up, or hardens up. Be careful when you do your eyelashes, because the glue, if you push too hard, it will spit out a lot. Let that sit for a minute, because you want it to get sticky. You don't want to put the eyelashes on right away. I like to blow on it a little bit. Let me stop playing around. You can hear it. Phlegm in my throat. Need that sticky or it's gonna come up a lot. Here's the tricky part. Get it over with. You could use tweezers or the eyelash tweezer thing that sometimes comes with in a eyelash box. I just use my fingers. It's just easier for me. That's another reason why I like thicker band eyelashes, because I get more of the glue on there and it'll stick right away. So before I play with that, I'm gonna let that dry. Make sure you're careful again, guys. The other one worked with me, so let's hope this one does too. Damn it. So smear it on my thing. Got a funky smile. Oh, shit.
Sorry, I did not mean to. Nice. It's not too. Looks kind of like more natural. So. Want it close to your. This one rises up. This is why I like the thicker. Where's the tweezer? Now I like to go in with mascara and blend your real eyelash with the fake. Wow. That actually doesn't look natural anymore now that I mix. You have to blend your mascara with your fake eyelashes so your real eyelashes blends in with your. Ah, I almost put myself in the bam eye. There we go, I need to wash my mouth. Perfect. Fan since it's messed with my eyelashes and mascara. Any fallouts of like dried up eyeliner or mascara, I just clean it off. Okay. Do the color bottom of my. Oh crap. I'm just gonna go in with this for it. Actually, I had my. Did I have my Kat Von D palette out? Just gonna take a brown. Now you can put, if you want to pop a little bit more in natural state, you can put concealer. Going go a little darker at the end.
I'll clean that up.
Sorry, like I said, my dad and I got a new TV.
Brighten my inside corner.
And I'm actually gonna use a highlight that I do on my cheekbones. I'm gonna pop it out here since we get shimmer.
Look how beautiful that looks.
I did a good job.
Alright. What was I gonna do? Oh, highlight. I'm using my new highlighter. Now, that Carly Bible has the highlights in there as well, but I'm gonna try this one, the Anastasia. This is another product I haven't tried before. And I'm just gonna go in the inner corner of my eye. Put that there.
Let's go ahead and use this one. Ooh. Two. On the roof. That's nice. Let's mix it with something else. How about I do a purple? Just for fun. Okay. Now I'm going to do my highlights. Now, y'all know my trick. The cream highlight, then set with powder. You hear me? It will work. That phallus scar that I use, that I'm ordering the oil, you can set that with your highlight too. This is the cream. I'm using the Urban Decay Sin Cream Highlight. See how beautiful that is? You just want on top of your cheekbones. God, this flood needs to go away. We'll fix it. If it's too much, we fix it. I go on the bridge of my nose. Keep it slow. I'm going to fix that. And all I do is smooth it out with my finger. Okay, I'm gonna take my brush and fix even this out. It's just a leftover from the leftover blush. I don't add more blush. It's just a leftover blush for what I used earlier. Just kind of straighten out the line. Now I'm gonna go back in with the Anastasia. Highlight. Where's my highlight brush? Here. I used the Makeup Addiction, the Queen highlight. Let's go ahead and just do a pick. Let's pick, let's do Lyra. We'll do Lyra. Lyra's pretty name. Now I did the cream highlight, now I'm going in with the powder. The Huda Beauty. I want that so bad. I want her eyeshadow palette and her Glow Kids. The rose palette. I'm just doing light strokes because I don't need too crazy, you know? But I love it on my. Wow, that's so pretty. I'll go crazy with highlight on my nose. Alright. Let's get my eye. Don't worry, guys, I'm pretty much done. So. It's time. I can see why. Now I'm going to try my new Buxom lipsticks and gloss. Pick that up. Didn't even open it. Come on. Probably been on here for like 3 hours now. That's what it feels like. This is color. We'll do this one. This is the Buxom Dolly Danger with the gloss. Rose Julep. Remember, Buxom is a plump. Ooh, that's different. Why do you do that? What's that? What is that? What is this? What is that? Does it say? It doesn't even say. I've never seen that before. Unless I. Oh, featuring built-in brushes for blending and contouring. Okay. I was about to say, because it doesn't make sense. Alright. It plumps your lips. So. Not that my lips need much plumping. Oh, just so you know, earlier I did the exfoliating on the lips after I washed my face, y'all. Ah! That's good, Rita. Well, that really doesn't come off. Right. Tristan's getting mad. That's what I'm getting towards in that time. It's getting up towards his nap time anyway, so.
That's pretty. I guess you. I was just trying out, see how it is. And I'm gonna put the gloss. Lumpin' time. Oh, I love that tingling. Finally done. Yeah, this girl, this effort is finally done. I'm just setting it with my setting spray, the Urban Decay. I know I spray a lot. I like that, just refreshing feeling. All right, I'm done here. Aw, thank you, Ashley. You can still see the wetness on my face. So, thank you for watching this boring one with me today. I didn't really talk as much. But, yeah. There's reasons why. I just wanted to do it, just take my mind off of stuff. Alright, I will talk to you guys later. This is the final look. I love the eyeshadow. This is so pretty. The Carly by Belle. The shimmer. You see the shimmer? I love it. Love it, love it, love it. So, thank you guys for watching. Bye.